Today's topic is electric charge. So first I will discuss about the definition of the electric charge. What is the definition? The definition says that it is the property of electron or proton which gives rise to an electric force between them. That means it is the property of the electron and proton. You know that electrons and protons are the two charged particles. You have studied in your chemistry that proton carries positive charge and electron carries negative charge. So again here in this chapter, as we are studying electric charge, the definition comes like this. The proton or electron, it is the property of proton or electron which gives rise to an electric force. In 11th class you have studied about gravitational force, but here it is electric force. And in our gravitational force is always attractive in nature, but later we will see electric force is attractive in nature, repulsive in nature. So another definition of charge also I can write. Okay, it is the properties of matter. It is the property of a matter due to which an electric force is experienced. That means in both cases a common force is there. The definition says that electric force is experienced. That means if a charge is needed to define, so I can define a charge. A charge is nothing but the region of an electric force. Means who creates an electric force? This is the charge. It's the simple definition. A charge creates an electric force. Okay. So the definition is very simple. The charge creates an electric force. So now I will come to a very important topic, which is electrostatic. So it comes under electric charge. Now what is electrostatic? Electrostatic is the branch of science, is the branch of physics, you can say, is the branch of physics where it deals with charge at rest condition. That means if charges are not moving anywhere, or if charges are not accelerating anywhere, any point to any point, they all are rest condition. So if charges are rest condition, this is known as electrostatic. And basically in this chapter I will teach about the charge at rest condition. And in next chapter, when I will move to current electricity, in this case I will assume that my charges are moving in a velocity. Okay, so electric charge definition is over, and electric charge definition is over. So now a very important concept you need to know, that is what is electrostatic series. What is electrostatic series? Okay, electrostatic series is glass, wool, silk, paper, cotton. So here I have written four materials, right? Glass, wool, silk, paper, cotton. So there you will find an electrostatic series. Here you will find the list of material like this. So just make an arrow mark like this from top to bottom. The material in top is very weak in holding electron, and the material down is very strong in holding electron. So why am I saying this? Because very first timing our mankind means when the concept of charge were not established, for the very first time scientist Benjamin Franklin, he named the charge as positive negative. Okay, so before that people were finding that if certain material are having friction with certain materials, then they carry a force. Suppose I will use so what is the logic of this field, the logic of the series? The down you will move is very strong in holding electron, the up is very weak in holding electron. That means if I will rub glass with a cotton, the glass is very weak in holding electron. So it's very weak in holding electron means it will lose electron to cotton, and cotton is very strong, so cotton will not lose electron. So you have to remember the series. In the series there are certain materials placed like this, and you have to go like this, means top down approach. So question will be that, okay, question will be that if glass will be rubbed with cotton, so who will be positive and who will be negative? So before describing that, let me clear one thing. If a body lost electron, it becomes positive. You know this, it is already taught to you. If a body gains electron, it becomes negative. So you just remember these two things: when a body lost electron, it becomes positive; when a body gains electron, it becomes negative. So in this case, if I ask if glass is rubbed with paper or glass is rubbed with cotton, then who will carry which type of charge? So glass is very weak, the upper is very weak. According to the series, the glass will be losing electron. Losing electron means positive. And the paper or cotton, they are below the glass, they will negative. They will gain electron. Okay? Because they are very strong in holding electron. So you have to remember like this: glass, wool, silk, paper, cotton. Like this, the elements are stored. Means elements are placed and forming a series. And it is known as electrostatic series. Because it is important, because sometimes in exam they may ask if certain material is rubbed with another material, then which type of charge will be created. So you have to remember this series. Okay, I will later share the series detailed, because in series there are many materials. I have just mentioned 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 30-40 materials in the series. So again, the top will be very weak in holding electron, and later if you go down, they will be very strong in holding electron. So similarly, if I rub wool with cotton, so wool will be again positive, cotton will be negative. If I rub silk with cotton, silk will be positive, cotton will be negative. That means silk is in the up place and cotton is in the down place. So silk is very weak in holding electron, so it will lose electron. It is losing electron, then it will become positive. And it is gaining electron, means it will become negative. So electrostatic series, you need to remember the series, and after remembering the series, it will be helpful to get the answer that which material will be positive and which material will be negative after rubbing with each other. Okay. So in the very next session, I will be discussing two things, that is property of charges. As I have defined charge, now I will go to the property of charges, and secondly I will go to the methods of charging. Okay, so in property of charges, I will encounter. Now first, I will tell about properties of charges. So properties of charges. In properties of charges, there are, I will find three charges, three properties. The first is additive property. The second is quantization property. And the third is conservation property. So additive properties. As you know that charges two type, okay, positive, negative. So simply additive properties is that it follows the algebraic addition formula. Algebraic addition formula means if there are three charges, -5 + 4 - 3, and what will be the total charge? In this case, you have to add -5 + 4 - 3. So -5 - 3 - 8 - 8 + 4 - 4. So total charge will be -4. The way you are adding in algebraical, in algebra, this will be followed here also in addition of charges. This is the very first property. So you can add charge like you are adding in algebra. So second property of charge is quantization. And what does it mean? Quantization is meaning that the smallest charge carrier is electron, and it carries a charge of -1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. Okay, so this is the amount of electronic charge. And quantization property says that the total amount of charge is equal to Ne. That means N is the number of electron and E is the electronic charge. Okay, in quantization property is nothing but you have to write the total charge contained inside a body is nothing but the product of number of electrons, transport or gain. Because you can't charge a body, just transfer of electron and transfer of electrons happens. Okay, it may be go away from the body and it comes to the body. It depends. So let me clear one thing. Okay, what is conservation and which types of problems will be asked in conservation? Quantization. In quantization, they will ask if a body emitting 10⁻¹⁹ electrons, then what is the, if a body emitting means what? It is giving, it is not taking, it is giving electrons. So you know that if I am giving electrons, I will be positive charge. If I am taking electrons, I will be negative charge. If a body gives 10⁻¹⁹ electrons, that means it is giving electrons. So definitely it will be positive charge. And what is the amount of that charge? That of charge amount is Ne. So it implies that plus N is what? Number of electrons. It's nothing but 10⁻¹⁹ into 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. So what happens? 1.6 coulomb. That means if a body gives 10⁻¹⁹ electrons, it have 1.6 coulomb. And here the question arises, what is coulomb? Coulomb is the unit of charge. And very next class I will teach a Coulomb's law is there. I will teach Coulomb's law. As the Coulomb is the first person who gave a law which deals with the force between two charges. Okay. If two charges are there, then there will be a force. This is nothing but the electric force. And Coulomb is the person who gave the law for the very first time. So unit of charge is Coulomb. C. Unit of charge is Coulomb. Okay. So it is about quantization charge. And what is about conservation charge? Conservation of charge is that the total charge remains constant. Total charge remains constant in an isolated system. That means you can say also like this, the way you are saying the conservation of energy, the energy neither be created nor be destroyed, you just transform from one form to another. Similarly, charges also neither be created can nor be destroyed. That means charges only occur by transferring electrons. That means if I am interested to charge a body, okay, I will transfer electron to that body by any meaning. If I will be able to transfer electron to that body, the body will be negatively charged. If I will take away the electron, the body will be positively charged. So it is very much clear that adding electron or taking electron from a body creates charging. So charge is only the method of transferring electron. So it is clear that the charge is neither be created nor be destroyed. It just transforms from one form to another form. So in the properties of charges, these three will be very important. They will ask a question like define electric charge and write the properties of charges. In this you have to write three different properties. Now I'll teach about methods of charging. So it is very much clear, two types of charge, one is positive, one is negative. And the most important thing, I have not said three laws of charge. The first law, same charge repel different charge attract, and charge body also attract, charge body also attract a neutral body. Okay, you have to remember like this: same charge repel with each other, different charge attract with each other, and a charged body is there, then it will attract a neutral body. Okay, these three things you have to remember. So methods of charging, I can broadly classify as three methods. One is by friction, another by induction and conduction. So it is also very easy. So how friction? If you will rub two different materials, then what will happen? The electrons of A metal will transfer to another metal. I have said the transfer of electron nothing but charging process. So friction here is the reason which creates a charge. So you can say if I will rub A with B, okay, then if A comes in the top list of the electrostatic series which I was discussing, then A is having a weaker control on electron, so A will lose electron, so A will be positive. And if B is at the lower side of the series, the B will be negative. So it is very much clear that A, B are getting charged due to friction. Okay, after friction what happens? Electrons get transferred from one to another. So now I will come to induction. In induction what happens? If a charged body which is positively charged brings very close to a surface, so what happens? Suppose these are A and B. So what happens? If it is very close to this, then it is a positive charge. So what happens here? The total charge is neutral. That means positive and negatives are equal. But when it come very closer to this, so negatives are getting attracted, and a negative charge is developed here. Okay, as a negative is developed here, automatically positives will go to that side. If positive will go to that side, then here also a negative will be developed. So this is the method of induction. Basically you have to remember in one line, when a positive charge is being nearer to a neutral body, a negative is induced, if I will bring the different case. Okay, if I will bring the negative charge body, then what will happen? Then positive will be induced, and this side will be negative. Again, this side will be positive. So you have to remember induction. In induction, what happens when a charge body is brought to near a uncharged body? The opposite type of charges are getting induced. If a positive charge you are bringing very close, the negative is induced. If you are bringing negative to very close, a positive is induced. Opposite charge induced. Induced means is created. Okay. And what is the reason of this induction? This is the reason. If you are not bringing, then there is no case of creating any charges. As you are bringing a charged body to nearer to the uncharged body, so charges are getting induced. This is the method of induction. And in method of conduction, what happens? In method of induction, they are not in actual contact. They are not in contact. Okay? Very close. Very close, but not in contact. But in conduction, they are in contact. That means, if a body A is there, if a body B is there, okay, I will connect them by a metallic wire. So this metallic wire conduct the charge from A to B. Suppose A is at A is charged. Now charge will flow to this B by this wire. So in conduction also you have to write in one line that the charging by conduction of the charge, okay, by actual transfer of the charge using a conductor. So what is the meaning? By using a conductor, if I am able to charge a body with the help of a charged body, then you can say this is the charging method, and the method is known as method of charging by conduction. Okay. So in very next class, I will be teaching about Coulomb's law, okay, and Coulomb's law and electric field. Till then, bye. Thank you.